Welcome to your optimal control tutorials. The question that we'll answer today is, how should the brain act? First, let me introduce Zhongwei Wu, who created both of your optimal control tutorials. Zhongwei is a postdoc who works in the lab with me, and a fun fact is that she's the only one in lab who could actually solve this geared puzzle cube. Go Zhongwei. Today we'll talk about the perception action loop, where an observer gets to make measurements of the world and take actions accordingly in such a way as to maximize their expected value. This involves having an internal model of how the dynamics of the world work and what is valuable for the agent. Bayesian modeling is something that allows us to have some key tools that formalize and understand this perception action loop. And the core ingredients are things that we've already covered earlier in the week. In particular, Tuesday and Wednesday, we covered models for time series and also how to integrate measurements over time. And today and tomorrow, we're going to use those tools to go beyond perception and include action. We'll begin with a Markov decision process, which Maurice introduced briefly earlier in the intro. This is a sequential decision-making process where, again, you're trying to maximize your rewards or your utility. Here, the current world state is observable. You get to see exactly what there is in the world right now, but you don't know the future. So we have a state, which is ST, and we have actions, AT, and we know the transitions, what the future state probabilities are, given the current state and the different actions that you can take. This is why we call this our Markovian process, because the future distribution only depends on the present state. There's only a one time step history. Now we also have rewards or utilities, which depend on the state and the action that you chose. And we have a policy which defines what do you do, what actions do you select from each state that you observe. And all of those together give us a value, which is something that the animal is trying to optimize. It's a value for each state. Now we can make this into a diagram where the world state is evolving over time. This should look familiar to you from Sean's lecture on day 3 of this week. The world state evolves over time, but now the updates depend on what you do. So you can take actions that change the evolution of the state compared to if it was evolving independently. And you can see that over here, that the transition probability used to be in just a hidden Markov, Markov model, P of S at T plus 1 given S at T. And now there's this additional action dependence, which is represented by two arrows coming into the state, one from the previous state and the other from your action. And your action is determined by the previous state as well through the policy here. Now, both the state and the action are giving you rewards, and those rewards are what you're trying to optimize, the long-term expected reward. Now, let's consider instead a partially observable Markov decision process, or a POMDP. Now, you do not get to observe the world state. It's uncertain because you have only partial observations about it. Now, on the other hand, you do know what uncertainty you have. That uncertainty is known, it's your posterior. However, you of course don't know the future of the world state, but you also don't even know what your future uncertainty will be. Okay, so this is a more uncertain situation, and yet you still have to make decisions. Now let's go again to the different ingredients that we have for a Markov decision process and see how we change them to incorporate partial observability. So the state becomes a belief state, which is a posterior. This is what we spent a lot of time learning about how to calculate in day 3 in the hidden Markov model. Now we have a probability of that state given the whole history of measurements. Those are observations, sensory observations, and the whole history of the actions that you've taken. That posterior we will call a belief and designate it by B. Now, you, in order to compute those beliefs, you need a new ingredient, which is your measurement, which we'll call M once again. And those measurements are the whole history. They're generated according to a hidden Markov model. Now, we still have the actions, but now the transitions that we have to consider are not just world transitions, but in fact, belief transitions. This is, given that you were in some belief state before, that you had obtained some measurements previously, what is the probability that you will enter a new belief state in the future at time t plus one? Similarly, whereas before we had a reward or utility that depended on the world state and action, now we have an expected utility which depends on the belief and the action. And finally, our policy that we will choose depends not on the world state, which again, we don't know, but only on our belief about that state or the posterior about that state. And finally, the value that we assess for this policy and for all of these ingredients is now a function of the belief as well. So certain belief states are valuable and others are less valuable. And we would like to choose actions that maximize our total expected future utility. That's going to give us the highest value. Now, if we go back to our diagram, here we include all of the arrows that we need in order to explain the dynamics here. Again, we have the world state, and that's evolving over time. But now the world state is emitting measurements, which we get to incorporate to generate our beliefs or our posteriors about the world. And these beliefs are updated according to the dynamics that we know about the world, that is the same assumed to be parallel to the world dynamics here, and the actions that we take, as well as the measurements that we observe. So we have this bouncing back and forth of information from the world, which gives measurements, updates our belief. Our belief then determines our actions, which then go back and affect the world state. Ping-ponging back and forth here. And once again, we get utility out of the world and out of our actions by getting a utility function that depends on the state and the actions. But ultimately, our evaluation is dependent on what we can observe or what we can know, which is not the world state, but instead the belief about it. So our utility will finally depend on the belief, not the world state. Okay, so we can make a parallel here. MDPs, or Markov decision processes, are interactive Markov models. And POMDPs, or partially observable Markov decision processes, are interactive hidden Markov models. We're going to continue these running examples that we've had throughout the week with a binary and continuous variable. On Wednesday, you found a posterior over the current hidden state using the measurements that you make. And we used the telegraph process, which was a binary HMM. And we also considered a continuous linear dynamical system with Gaussian noise, Gaussian process noise and observation noise, which gave us the Kalman filter. Now today, you'll learn how to take actions based on those hidden Markov model inferences. We'll contrast, in the second tutorial, we'll contrast optimal control in open and closed loop states. Open loop control is going to solve one of these decision processes when you don't have any measurements. You know what you think the dynamics are, you make a guess about what's going to happen, and you try to make the best control possible. You can do better if you get to continuously measure the world, and then that gives you closed loop control, which will solve these decision processes with measurements. Our two tutorials will be based on a binary and continuous variable, and the first one we'll consider as an application to phishing. You will control a binary latent variable, and that's going to continue from what you've seen before about a binary hidden Markov model, and it will connect to reinforcement learning, which you will study tomorrow. In the second tutorial, we'll consider how to fly. and catch a target. And that will be modeled by linear optimal control of a continuous state. And it's going to continue from the linear dynamics that we learned on Tuesday and the Kalman filter that we learned on Wednesday. So here we go, tutorial 1, gone fishing.